What's good? What's up, Messy Mob? It's your girl, Messy Maya, and I am back again with another video. So I'm not going to lie. I am absolutely done watching Boring Boys Texas. I'm not watching that shit anymore. They're not bad boys. They are bitches. So I'm not watching that shit no more. I honestly don't like it. The only person that I like is Jonathan Arvra, and I like Adonis a little bit. Everyone else can kiss my ass. So I'm gonna come with the Baddies content instead, because Bad Boys, Boring Boys, it's just not doing it for me. So yeah. Also, shout out to this TikTok creator for the edit at the beginning. Girl, all of her edits absolutely eat down. So go ahead and follow her whenever you get the chance. And let's get into this motherfucking video. Let's go. Okay, so I know when y'all read that title or seen the thumbnail, y'all probably was like, what is this bitch talking about now? Because y'all know I'm gonna come through with the unpopular opinions. I'm going to say what everyone else doesn't want to say, or they just feel the opposite. I'm gonna say it because I really don't give a damn. I feel how I feel. I feel like Biggie should come back for Baddies East. Hear me out. Okay. They probably like, y'all probably like, why the fuck? Who the fuck? Why the fuck? Where the fuck? And who the fuck? Because why is she talking about Biggie need to come back for another season when she was obsessed with Stunner Girl and annoying as fuck? I know. Listen, but hear me out. I know this is not a video that is going to be, well, I'm going to be praising Biggie a little bit because I feel like she has some demon qualities that'll go good with Baddies East. But please know, I am well aware of how annoying she may have came off on the season. Trust me, we're going to get into it all. Okay. All right. Listen, I hold everybody accountable. So let's talk about it. Okay, so as much as we may or may not like Biggie, she was funny. Okay, so y'all go sit here and tell me Biggie wasn't funny. You go sit here and tell me Biggie was funny. Okay? Biggie was funny. I honestly, Biggie made me laugh. And then with a show like Baddies East or Baddies, the whole Baddies franchise in general, child, Zeus in general, when there's no storyline, when there's no plot, when there's no substance to the show, we need someone who is going to be funny, okay? Naturally funny, okay? And she's funny. From the little joke she cracks to her dancing, breaking out dancing out of nowhere, like her shit talking, like I said, she cracks jokes. She speaks fucking Spanish out of nowhere. It's funny to me. It's funny. The show needs comedic relief because at the end of the day, we all know we love the show, but we all know that the fight scenes drag. Without the fights, sometimes it can fall flat and it can get a little boring. So that's where I feel like the girl's personality has to come in to make the show a little bit more interesting. And I feel like Biggie has personality. Okay. She's funny. Don't believe me? Let's roll the clip. And then you tell me she's not funny. Bitch, I'm big Dominican. And I can't wait to put my Dominican money. Running your shit. Now I'm loving your shit, bitch. Bitch, I'm catching you later on, nigga. And I'm gonna get off at the one I'm not going. But I'm gonna say that I'm not gonna get off. Look at Rolly, Razor, Natalie, and Scotty fucking cracking up in the corner.
What's your name on your butt?
Yeah, isn't that cute? Hey,
Rolly. As we're walking to the living room, Stunner Short Ass runs up on Biggie. And I'm just like, if there was no security right there, she would have just ripped her apart.
Oh, yeah. This bitch Stunner comes running. I'm like, whoa, nigga, you know what I'm saying? She trying to get his 30. She trying to get bumping. You know, I'm running circles around this bitch. This bitch is funny. I'm laughing at her.
I don't know how to fight. You don't know how to fight, bitch. Let go of me, bro. I'm a boss, bro. Bro, please. I'm a boss. Look.
You got to stay there.
No. Yeah, stay right there. Bro, I'm a motherfucking boss, bro. I don't fight little bitches like you. You look like shit. You look like shit. I'm a fat bitch. But I didn't take my shoes off from the club. Shaking your ass. Your pussy was out. Yeah. You're disgusting.
So she's not funny. So you're telling me she's not funny. Come on. She's funny. It's a comedic relief thing. You know what I'm saying? Here's my thing. I don't mind the drama. I really don't. Like, that's really why half of us tune in. It gives us the little bad girls club feel where they're put in the house and they are fighting. I get it. I understand. I don't mind the drama. But when the drama is dying down and the show starts to get boring and fall flat, you're going to want someone with a personality to make the show a little better. And that's why I feel like Biggie could come in. She's hilarious. She's funny. She's funny. Like, she be having me weak as fuck. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to lie. Okay. So when I say that she needs to get her lick back, I mean multiple things, okay? So of course, I'm talking about with Stunna Girl, and then we're going to get into that. And then I'm also talking about with the fans, because I feel like the fans really don't like Biggie. I feel like they threw dirt on Biggie's name because Biggie was hella annoying on the season. And I feel like Biggie was really just the laughing stock of baddies, if we're really going to talk about it. She really was. She was the butt of every joke on social media that had anything to do with baddies. And I'm not going to lie, I was one of the people who really didn't really fuck with her like that, because I feel like Biggie did a lot most of the time, okay? I feel like she was picking on Stunna Girl. It's like, girl, you don't even know this girl yet. Referring back to the first episode, you don't know this girl. This girl doesn't know you. You are basically basing an opinion off of a fight that she had with Tommie when she was getting her lick back off of something that Tommie started in the first place. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? It's like the fact that you were dick riding Tommie the very first episode. You and Tommie didn't even say two words to each other before then. It's like, girl. And then I feel like she was dick riding all the big dogs. She was dick riding Natalie. She was dick riding Rolly. And she was dick riding Tommie. And that shit backfired in her face. Okay, so at the end of the day, I feel like Biggie was the laughing stock of the season. So why not get her lick back? Why not have her come back for another season? And child, I know how y'all gonna be. Bitch, this ain't redemption. The fuck? This ain't no redemption, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Okay, cool. I get it. I understand. But y'all know how on Bad Girls Club season 9, how Julie was just this evil ass bitch. I'm talking about evil bitch, evil down to the core, bitch. Okay. But she came back for All-Star Battle season 1. She came back for Bad Girls Club season 13, Redemption, and she redeemed herself. And honestly, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody likes Julie now for the most part. But of course, we hated her on her season, but she came back for different spinoffs and she redeemed herself. Why can't Biggie do the same thing? That's all I'm saying, y'all. Okay, everybody deserves a second chance. Everybody. And I feel like, honestly, since Biggie did, this was like a trial and error for Biggie, okay? Let Baddies West be a trial and error. Bring her back for season 2, and I guarantee you she will not go in the way she did on Baddies West. I guarantee you. This is checkers, not chess. Sorry. This is chess, not checkers. Okay? This is chess, not checkers. Okay? Let her redeem herself. Because think about it. Just think about it and hear me out. So because Biggie went into Baddies West and ended Baddies West basically not being the most hated, but people really didn't like her like that. So if she does go on Baddies East, she's immediately going to go in as the underdog. Because again, fans already know her at this point. Fans already have what, you know what I'm saying? They already have an idea of how she's going to act. So girl, prove them wrong. That's what I'm saying. Get your fucking lick back. Come in as, she's immediately going to come in as the underdog. So girl, prove them wrong, get your lick back, learn from the lessons that you learned from Baddies West. Remember that for Baddies East, Rolly is not your friend, Tommie is not your friend, anybody that you just meet is not your friend. You know what I'm saying? Don't hate on a girl just because she fought someone that you want to be friends with or that you want to be on their side. because it's just gonna backfire. That shit backfired right in her face when she was defending Tommie. She was getting so mad about Tommie. She barely knew Tommie though. And that shit backfired right in her face.
I get Biggie calling me on the phone talking about, sis, they saying that you're not really my friend. And I said, bitch, believe him. Believe him, bitch. Believe him. Get the fuck off my phone, you too, bitch. Get the fuck off my motherfucking phone. I'm sick of all of you hoes at this point. I'm aggravated. A simple thing.
So I really think that if she does, if she's smart, child, if she's smart, she will learn her lesson and do better. That's what I'm saying. Everybody does.
Learn something from this.
So when I was planning this video, I put this down as one of the bullet points. But then as I started to make the video and talk about it, I started thinking to myself, damn. Can Biggie really fight? You know what I'm saying? Like, she got the best of Stunna Girl that one time where she kind of snuck her, but she still sat her ass down on that motherfucking couch, okay?
Yours.
So many bitches said they've been fucking you.
What? I'm sorry?
Okay, so she punched the shit out of Stunna Girl and then sat her down. But I feel like after that, when the fight went on and on and on, I feel like Biggie really didn't do much. And honestly, at that point, I was like, damn, she's really just big for no reason. Like, she really, because I seen hella girls where, like, they're strong as fuck, but they don't know how to fight. Like, it's the difference between being strong and having strength and actually knowing how to maneuver within a fight. You know what I'm saying? It's completely different. So she could just be strong. But I feel like after that, like, Stunna Girl is way more smaller than you. I feel like she let Stunna Girl get the best of her. And y'all can honestly tell me how y'all felt about that fight. But they had 3 rounds. I feel like, okay, so I'm not going to say all 3 rounds. But I feel like at least 2 out of the 3 rounds of that fight between her and Stunna Girl, I feel like Stunna Girl definitely got the best of her. And then at the reunion, when Stunna Girl ran up on her, I still feel like she really didn't do much.
Hold on, whoa, 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 hold on, wait, bro, whoa.
Yeah, bitch, drop your stupid ass.
Y'all let me know. So it could have been because security got in the way fast as fuck. And like, security really did not want them to fight during the reunion. But it could be because security intervened very quickly. But I feel like Biggie didn't do much in that fight either. You know what I'm saying? So y'all let me know if y'all feel like Biggie can fight or not. But at the end of the day, my point is, because I feel like I literally just contradicted myself. But at the end of the day, the point is Biggie will fight if she feels like she has to. You know what I'm saying? Like, she's not gonna fight. Like, she will fight, clearly. You know what I'm saying? If the bitch don't like you enough, she will fight you. That's how I feel. And you clearly have to have that quality to be on Baddies. So she got it. Also, I also forgot to mention this back on the other segment where I said she needs to get her lick back immediately. So I mentioned how she needs to get her lick back when it came to the fans and people basically dogging her online and making her the joke of the season. But she also needs to get her lick back with Stunna Girl. I'm gonna make this quick, but I'm gonna make my point. Okay, so Stunna Girl, again, I feel like Stunna Girl got the best. I'm not gonna sit here and lie and say that Stunna Girl just beat the shit out of her, but I feel like in some of the fights with Stunna Girl, I feel like Stunna Girl got the best of Biggie. Okay, and it's like, girl, Stunna Girl, girl, ain't no way that girl should have should have got the best of you like that. Okay, girl, you are 10 times bigger than that girl. Get it together. Anyway. Okay, so not only that, but it's like, Biggie, Stunna Girl snatched your chain. Like, that is like embarrassing as fuck. Like, it doesn't get any worse than that. No, it does get worse than that. Stunna Girl also chased you. She chased you. You ran from her, Biggie. Okay, it does get worse than the chain snatching. You ran from her, Biggie.
Yo, are you serious? Are you serious?
You know what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't get any embarrassing than that. This girl done snatched your chain And she ran you down, like literally ran you down. Like you were literally kicking, running from her. You know what I'm saying? Running. Okay. Call her Ruby Rose. Y'all know how Ruby Rose was running at the fucking Baddies East auditions. Call her Ruby Rose because that girl was kicking. Okay. Running. Okay. Child. She Biggie run fast as fuck. Biggie run fast as fuck. Like she was scared. Like. And I feel like, one, I feel like that would be great content for her to address that on TV and to get her look back. Like, that could be a storyline for the new season. Like, I'm thinking strategically. You know what I'm saying? I'm thinking strategically. That would be a really good storyline for the season. That's what I'm saying. If she was to go into Baddies East, she would go in as the fucking underdog. So tell me she wouldn't. She would. Because first of all, bitch, half of America feels like you're scary. You know what I'm saying? They feel like you're scared because you done ran from this little munchkin. Don't come for me because I love Stunner Girl. But she is very little. You done ran from this little munchkin, okay? With the little chipmunk voice. You done ran from her after talking all that shit online and after talking all that shit in the house. You know what I'm saying? Not only that, but you let her get the best of you in half the fights that y'all, that, you know what I'm saying? Half the fights that y'all got in, you let Stunner Girl get the best of you. And three, you let her snatch your chain, put it in her ass, and throw it in the tree. Biggie, baby, you got to get your look back, baby. Like, there's no other way. Zeus, please bring this girl back so she can get her lick back. I meant to say that in the last one, but I completely forgot. But I'm saying it now. She needs to get her lick back. She needs to redeem herself. So no one's catching on. Are y'all still not convinced yet? Let me know in the comments. I know that this is going to rub a few people the wrong way, but just because Biggie is big, I feel like that really doesn't mean anything because I feel like she knows what looks good on her. I feel like she puts that shit on. I'm not gonna lie. And no shade towards Rolly, but I feel like that's why Rolly really doesn't like Biggie like that, because I feel like Biggie is confident within her own skin. Biggie knows that she is big, but she doesn't let that stop anything, okay? So Biggie's wardrobe is amazing, and I honestly feel like I said, no shade to Rolly, but I feel like, girl, wherever Biggie be shopping at, whatever plus size store, boutique, whatever that Biggie be shopping at, girl, I feel like you need to go, girl, because the cheetah print, I'm tired of it, okay? The outfit at the reunion wasn't giving. Half the outfits you wear, it's just not giving, and it honestly has nothing to do with her body shape. I feel like Rolly just doesn't know what looks good on her yet, okay? Biggie knows what looks good on her, and she puts that shit on. Let's get into it. So if we're really talking about the aesthetic of being a baddie, like being able to dress, being your own boss, I feel like Biggie puts that shit on. You know what I'm saying? Because if you actually go down her page, she actually has a, you know what I'm saying? She does what she does as, a party promoter, coordinator, whatever, okay? She actually does what she does. She actually brings celebrities out to her city. You know what I'm saying? And not only that, but the girl can dress. The girl knows what is good for her, what works for her, and she puts that shit on, in my opinion. Y'all let me know what y'all feel about Biggie and the way that she dressed and the way that she looks. And I feel like she just puts that shit on. I feel like her hair is always done. Even when she got into the fight with Stunner and Stunner Girl kept grabbing her by her fucking hair. Her hair, I mean, it was wild, of course, because she had just fought. But for the most part, Stunner Girl ain't ripped nothing out. Ain't no wig come off, nothing, girl. I feel like for the most part, her hair was still in place. You know what I'm saying? So, and so was it also at the reunion, too, when Stunner Girl snatched her ass up. So I feel like she cares the way that she looks, because it's one thing. And that's the thing about Rolly too. I feel like a lot of times, like, you're supposed to be on this Baddies West show. I'm sorry, Baddies East, Baddies West, child, Baddies South, whatever, child. She was on damn near all of them. But the thing is that you're supposed to care how you look. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like sometimes Rolly really does not give a fuck how she looks. I feel like she doesn't. But on the other hand, you have Biggie, who whenever she steps out, she looks good. Except for that reunion outfit, child. I still don't know what the fuck was that, but she tried. You know what I'm saying? She still came. I feel like her outfit still looked better than Rolly's, okay? But I feel like for the most part, she puts that shit on. I feel like she is confident in the skin that she is in. The only problem where I feel like Biggie fell flat is she was trying way too hard to fit in. Way too hard. She was trying way too hard to fit in, and it just wasn't needed. It wasn't needed at all. But I feel like if she goes into the new season the way she was at the auditions, with a new mindset in her actual self, because honestly, I feel like production ruined her. I feel like the cameras ruined her. I feel like she tried to do too much for the cameras. But I feel like if she goes in with that same personality, her real personality that she came in at the auditions with, I feel like she would be fine.
Thank you so much, ladies. How are you? My name is Biggie. I'm from Providence, Rhode Island, 26 years old. As for me, you guys don't even have to ask me. I feel like I'm a baddie because, period, between my prayer, my dedication, and my execution, there is nobody that can get through me. And I kid you not, I don't care how anybody feels behind me, there's not one big girl in this fucking bitch that's making more money than me or repping harder for this shit. And that's on period.
So y'all telling me if she don't come in like this, the way that she was supposed to come in, without trying to impress people and trying to fit in and trying to get on certain people's side, you telling me that she won't be fan favorite or at least redeem herself from last season? I feel like me personally, and I would hate to fucking, I would hate to be the bitch that is sitting here trying to make up excuses for a grown-ass woman. I get it, okay? I understand. I understand for most people, Biggie is Biggie, and y'all feel like the damage is done, and there's really no coming back from it. I get it, okay? Trust me. But here's my thing. Does she not deserve a second chance? Like, if she were to come in to the new season acting like herself and not letting production get to her, or fucking, or trying to put on for the cameras, or trying to put on for the big dogs or whatever, if she comes in, lesson learned from the previous season, and come in herself a little bit more humble, you know what I'm saying? You're telling me that you're not gonna like her, or at least you're not gonna like her a little bit better than last season. Okay, so let me know if I convinced you yet, if Biggie should be on the next season. And if you're like, girl, no, girl, you ain't convinced me, girl, you are stubborn, okay? But I still love you for sticking through with me and at least listening and hearing me out. You know what I'm saying? I still love you, girl, but you stubborn, girl, okay? But let me know if I did convince you or not. It's Messy Maya. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Bye! I'm so alive, I'm so alive.